Organoids are very artificial structures that can be grown from stem cells. They resemble real organs, not in all aspects, but in the essential aspects. And they could represent anything, a lung, a heart, a kidney, a liver. They allow us to study these organs in a petri dish rather than an animal or a human being. But we also think we can use them for precision medicine by creating organoids from patients with a particular disease and find the best drug for that particular patient using the patient's own organoids. It was believed for a long, long time that healthy cells cannot be cultured in the lab. They cannot be expanded outside the human body. We have been using cell lines for many years, and cell lines really are cancer-derived. So they come from tumors. They're not normal cells. They grow very well in a patient's body, unfortunately, but also in the dish. Only maybe 4, 5, 6 years ago did it become clear that actually you can take normal stem cells from an individual, culture them in the dish, and they feel happy if you provide the exact right conditions, meaning growth factors, amino acids, vitamins, etc., etc., that they feel so much at home that they will start doing what they are very good at, namely repairing tissues or creating new tissues. And these are healthy tissues if you take them from a healthy stem cell. So the challenge is really to for every kind of tissue, and we have hundreds of different tissues in our body, to find the exact right condition under which these stem cells feel happy enough to create a mini organ or an organoid. Yeah, so the ability to grow organoids from humans has a number of advantages. Very simply, it is cheaper, it's faster, it's more reliable than animal experimentation would be, or experimentation on humans. It allows many, many more possibilities for research. Drug development is probably helped a lot by just being developed at the moment by the ability to culture human cells rather than do testing in animals. And I think a major application will be in the future is the possibility to take tissues from an individual patient, culture those tissues in the lab, and these can, for instance, be cancer tissues. That in the lab expose these tissues to a whole range of a whole battery of drugs and find the very best drug for that tumor in a dish and therefore for the patient that you're trying to treat.